It would have been impossible for us to make this movie a few years ago.
Turning what they learned on King Kong to Avatar, what had brought their technology to another level for this movie to make our apes look real.
This is the first live-action film that has its main character as a thoughtful, feeling, self-aware animal. This is the ape's story.
Andy Serkis is unlike any other actor. He can inhabit characters that don't speak and emote in ways that you don't really see often in movies.
The basic usage of performance capture is to see it on the screen. You will see the apes, but they're apes which are infused with the heart and soul of an actor's performance.
If you can be blinded by the technology, you can find yourself weighed down by it. And I think Andy brings a spirit and an understanding and a simplicity. He's able to push the technology to one side and think about it in terms of just a real live-action performance.
This film is not possible without the work of Andy Serkis.
You have to trust me, but I'm gonna get you out of here.
Everybody's seen chimpanzees, everybody's seen orangutans. We know how they're supposed to look. So I think the bar in terms of needing to make photorealistic characters is really high.
So we had to go to the best people in the business to do visual effects in this movie. Weta had the experience from Kong, Avatar, and Lord of the Rings. One of the improvements in motion capture since Avatar really have to do with detail and the type of imagery that they're getting out of the cameras gives us more facial information. And that subtlety is what's gonna make the apes work, which is gonna be very different. You don't get a chance to look in apes' eyes like you will see in this movie.
We started with the concept art and we started to use those as the basis of designing our characters.
And then from there, it goes to the creatures department, which they're working on the whole muscular system, the skeletal system, and the way that the apes would actually move. Then it would come to the textures department, where we had to actually put in all the very fine wrinkles on all the characters.
At the same time, the model department are doing the groom, laying out the fur, and handing that off to shaders as well so that they can apply hair that then goes to the shots department where everything comes together.
So the creatures really do have the correct anatomical layers. They have muscles and fat and skin and make them as realistic as possible.
Obviously when you work with Weta, you can be safe in the knowledge that they're going to come up with something pretty great, but we were attempting to do something that had never been done before. And my first reaction to seeing it was, that's Andy Serkis looking like a chimp. And that's what's so amazing, is you see his performance.
What we did differently on Rise of the Apes from what we did on Avatar is we brought performance capture into the live action location. Wham!
In a way, it's probably the best thing that happened to mocap. We've been shooting in the stage without sunlight for like 10 years.
We are on the set of the Golden Gate Bridge. This is the largest mocap volume in the world and the first time it's been done outside. So Weta is basically changing all the rules with motion capture.
That was good.
We are breaking very new ground here.
Second three in the movie, you will believe.
It has the spectacle, it has the scope.
Weta have done something that's quite extraordinary.
Caesar!